Hey guys, it's Sandro here with just a quick video today that looks at the process of restoring badly weathered and faded plastic trims, such as this bumper's plastic panel, by using a heat gun. Now, the first and most important thing about this process is to ensure that the plastic trim is completely clean and bare. This car was given a thorough decontamination clean, in which this plastic was treated with iron and tar removal chemicals, as well as a water mineral deposit remover, and finally given a somewhat aggressive wipe down with a wax and grease remover. The thing to note here is that I'm going to use heat to resurface this plastic's finish and soften it to the point that any existing dirt or grime sitting on top will be permanently fused into the finish, which is something you do want to avoid if you really want the best possible outcome. As far as technique goes, the key here is to work slow and with the least heat possible to achieve the desired results. If you try and go too fast or use excessively high heat, you'll find that the finish may look slightly patchy or inconsistent, or even worse, you may damage or alter the plastic trim, especially if it has sharp lines or intricate details which can potentially be melted or flattened with too much heat. So a plastic trim such as this one should really take a good half hour to complete. Now, you obviously do need a bit of heat for it to work, and every heat gun is a little different, but generally about a quarter to a third of power or heat on your gun is about right. You'll find at first that it does take a minute or so for anything to happen if you're working with the right amount of heat, but once you start to see the plastic turn black, it'll happen really quickly. And you need to move the gun away onto your next area immediately and always keep the gun moving and never let it sit in just one spot. You'll also find that this process is far quicker if the plastic or weather is hot to start with, and likewise, it'll take a little longer if it's a cold day. Also remember that you're going to be creating some plastic fumes, so be sure to work in a well-ventilated area or even outside. This is actually a technique that I was shown a long time ago and I used to use more often, when these plastic bumpers and trims were a lot more common on cars. But as these days, most bumpers and exterior trims are either color-coded or have piano black plastic finishes, it's a little more rare to see these textured plastic panels on modern cars today. It's also not a method that I'll use every time I see a slightly faded plastic trim, as in many cases, a plastic restorer or even a coating can be enough to restore the trim. So this technique is really reserved for those badly weathered and faded plastic trims where other conventional restoration methods just don't work. As you can hopefully see, the bumper plastic is significantly changing back to the deep, rich black color it was originally. But as you'll also see, due to the excessive wear and damage that goes beyond the surface, some of the sun damage or even mineral deposit etchings can still slightly be seen in the finish. Now, it's not like they're jumping out or are anywhere near as bad as they were, but they still are present to some degree. At this stage, the last thing you want to do is try more heat to remove them or improve the finish, as it'll most likely lead to degrading the finish even further. So just allow the plastic a good hour to cool down, and using a product such as solution finish will greatly help achieve that almost perfect uniform finish, even on a plastic trim as bad as this one. Now, as mentioned, in many cases, if the plastic isn't as bad as this, solution finish can be more than enough to restore the trim on its own. And in some cases, if the plastic trim is only mildly faded, a ceramic or glass coating is a fantastic way to both restore and protect it. But in my experience, when dealing with black plastic trims that are this far gone, the heat gun followed by solution finish is by far the best method to achieve the best results. Work solution finish into the plastic trim for a good minute or two and allow it time to absorb into the plastic, usually an hour or so. Then give it a wipe down to remove any excess product. And if you're not happy with the finish, you can just repeat the process and a second time should really do it. Make sure you give solution finish a good 24 hours to fully dry before getting a wet or protecting it, or even 48 hours in colder climates. Now, after solution finish has fully dried and set, it shouldn't come off even with an IPA or alcohol-based wipe down. If it does, it either means that it hasn't yet set, or that the plastic wasn't properly prepared before you applied it. As a final step, I prefer to use a ceramic or glass coating to protect the plastic and finish from further UV damage in the future. Now, the solvents in the coating may pull up just the slightest amount of black dye from solution finish, but overall, if the trim was properly prepared and set, the coating won't remove the finish at all, and it'll actually be a fantastic way to protect it in the future. Now, the Jeep in this video was used for a couple of detailing training classes that I teach. And it was also used for a bit of testing with some compounds and a new coating system that I'll hopefully have a video to coming up that also explains why only half of this Jeep was paint corrected, and also some more details on the products and processes used. So look out for those videos. As always, I really hope you guys enjoyed and found this video useful. Please like, comment, and subscribe to this channel to show your support for these videos, and I'll see you guys soon.